Hello, my name is Dr. Nitika Parmar, and I am the Program Director of the MS in Biotechnology and Bioinformatics degree program. I've been with CSU Channel Islands since the year 2006, and I became the Program Director of this program in 2015. Simultaneously, I also serve as the Program Director of the Bridges to Stem Cell Therapy Grant Program on our campus. I received my PhD and a postdoctoral fellowship from UCLA and worked there as a scientist for a few years before moving to Channel Islands. For the next few minutes, I'd like to share a few things about our faculty, staff, and students that I think you should consider as you decide which graduate studies program you'll soon be selecting. Making this decision to attend a graduate school that fulfills your needs and provides you with expert education is key to securing a good job, and I strongly believe that our program at Channel Islands precisely does that, as evidenced by the trajectory of our students who have done very well, be it moving into the industry or academia or even professional schools. The thing that originally attracted me to our small campus, Channel Islands, is first of all, our campus is quite small and the class sizes are fairly small too. Second aspect is there is an excellent student to faculty ratio, which really is very beneficial for the students. And thirdly, our campus affords a very diverse student population, which was very important to me personally, because I like to interact with different kinds of students. From an educator's perspective, I think this is critical to a student's preparation for a very rewarding career for several very important reasons that I'll just mention briefly. First of all, the small student to faculty ratio enables a very close and personal interaction with the students, thus allowing the students to avail faculty readily and receive advice and guidance in a very efficient manner. Secondly, our MS Biotechnology program is very unique for a variety of reasons. This is a professional science master's degree program, commonly known as a PSM degree, and it caters to both working and non-working students. We offer two emphases within this program. First, biotechnology, and second, stem cell technology and lab management. The classes that we offer in this program, no matter what emphases you're placed in, are typically held in the evenings on weekdays as well as on Saturdays. Our faculty pool is very, very rich, very diverse, very highly accomplished, and those faculty bring the real world applications into the classroom. In fact, you'll be pleased to know that more than 70% of our instructors in this program are coming from the industry. The curriculum that we offer is very broad and provides students necessary skills, not only in the basic sciences, but also in areas such as law and regulation, management, production, and clinical trials, just to name a few. Ultimately, our program is very flexible and allows students to set their roadmaps and graduate based on their individual needs. The entire program is highly student-centered and allows students to conduct research both on campus through various courses as well as at off-site locations within the LA, Ventura, San Diego, and San Francisco counties via different kinds of internships. Thus, students are exposed to various avenues for hands-on research skills. In our extended university program, we have 82 full and part-time students in the MS Biotech program specifically. And among these, we are happy to include about 16 foreign students who come from such far away places such as India, China, Iran, Turkey, Nigeria, Bangladesh, as well as the United Kingdom. Our students tell us they've selected our program for several major reasons, including an exciting and diverse curriculum that I just spoke to you about a little bit earlier, small class size, which enables interaction between faculty and students in a very efficient manner, and thirdly, the presence of really accomplished and expert faculty. Whatever your reasons might be, we want you to know that my personal commitment is to make your experience here a very rewarding and enriching one. As a student in our MS Biotech program, you'll have opportunities to work alongside students that share your passion for growth and personal achievement, learn the latest theory and practical applications taught by our distinctive and accomplished faculty, acquire skills and knowledge that will allow you to make important contributions in your career upon graduation, and start earning salaries that will provide a significant return on your financial and personal investments. I would briefly like to talk about our curriculum now. The coursework in this MS Biotech program involves completion of a variety of courses and includes topics such as molecular biology, genomics and proteomics, biotech law and regulation, bioinformatics, clinical trials, project management, biomedical engineering, stem cell techniques, molecular structure, just to name a few. We offer courses that are conducted online, in person, as well as in the form of a hybrid format. Several of our courses are lab-based, affording students hands-on skills, which are very necessary in the degree program. CSU Channel Islands students who have completed this particular MS in Biotech degree program have gone on to enjoy very successful careers in fields such as research and development, stem cell technology, regenerative medicine, quality control, clinical sciences, management, patent law, bioprocessing, manufacturing and production, as well as in professional schools. I'm really, really proud of our very gifted, accomplished and caring faculty. The Cal State University system is focused on teaching and student results as opposed to research. Our students benefit from a faculty group that has a combination of academic and real-world practical experience. A few notable highlights of our faculty include Dr. Bill Tawil, who teaches three courses for us in the area of biomedical engineering, focusing on biorobotics and a lot of different kinds of cool areas. He conducts extensive research with our students on campus and rapidly publishes papers with students as co-authors. Currently, Dr. Tawil is the director of the program at Abbott Medical. Then we have Dr. Thomas Scholes, who is a senior consultant in pharmaceutical development programs for Action for Results. He is also the founder and president of Teon Biopharma Consulting Incorporation. Dr. Scholes is an international R&D executive with significant R&D experience gained at Bayer, Baxter, Allergan, and Amgen. His core expertise is in medicinal chemistry, program management, and drug commercialization. We have Dr. Israel Hernandez, who is currently a scientist at UC Santa Barbara and studies neuronal diseases using induced pluripotent stem cells. We also have Dr. Panda Kroll, who is an attorney at law, and she is currently serving as the president at American Inns of Court, Ventura County Chapter. We also have Dr. Tim Osland, who worked at Amgen as a principal scientist in process development for 30 years. His expertise is in the areas of protein biochemistry and protein formulation. This, of course, is just a small representation of a terrific faculty. I would also like you to know that 95% of our faculty actually have a PhD. I believe that the best way to judge our faculty is by the successes that our graduates have gone on to enjoy. We have many, many examples of Dolphin alums who have gone on to make important contributions to the communities. I really cannot mention enough. We have absolutely amazing students who have done fantastic things after they've graduated. I can just mention a few here. One of our graduate students, Ken Diffenduffer, went on to work as a director in the stem cell core facility at the Salk Institute located in San Diego. Ken was a Bridges stem cell intern and conducted an internship at the Salk Institute. After graduating, he worked as a research associate there and quickly moved up the ladder to become the lab manager, and recently he became the director of the stem cell core. Then we also have Lance Mitz. He's another stellar student who is currently working at Novartis Gene Therapies. We also have Malika Singh, who is a senior manager and global head for IAL distribution at Regeneron in Boston. And of course, we do know, as a result of the pandemic, the company Regeneron is playing a very major role in offering antibodies for counteracting the COVID-19 pandemic. A sizable number of our students are currently at Amgen, such as Mary Solveson and Ramya Kirti, just to name a few. So our students are doing really, really well after they've graduated from our program. So in conclusion, I'd like to end by saying that at CSU Channel Islands, we understand that you have many higher education opportunities to choose from. We believe that your academic success is partly about a close fit between all the things our extended education program offers and your unique interests, needs, and career goals. I hope you'll check us out by attending a virtual campus tour or information session. Please feel free to call any of our admissions advisors to discuss your program interests. For more information, please also visit our extended university website for application deadlines, program descriptions, curriculum details, and to learn more about our faculty. I hope you will consider joining our program, and I assure you, you will not be disappointed. This is a very fine and unique program that we offer. So I look forward to hearing from you, and thank you so much for your time. Good luck to all of you. Thank you.